got a big goddamn problem with the news. You ready for this? The news is completely manipulated. Everything you hear every single day is designed by corporate media to do one thing and one thing only.
Jesus.
To keep you living in fear.
Oh, fear.
Total fear. Fear so you'll go out and you'll spend money on things. Things you probably don't even need. Things you probably already have six of. So that their advertisers will keep buying ads on their stations. I'll tell you one more thing. You ready for this? I'll do this all day, man.
This Qurba, this consciousness that Allah is close to us, it has been there in all religions. They call it the mystic way of life. Hinduism produced great mystics, great mystics. Buddhism created great mystics. Gautam Buddha himself, Nirvana, mysticism. And of course, the Christian world knows of the great mystics of Christianity and the great mystics of Judaism. We live in an age today when the light is disappearing. And we have people in parliament who have no light at all in them. None. They have their PhDs, yes, but inside is nothing. And Islam also produced the great spiritual giants.
The Prophet himself, alayhi salatu wasalam, said, he's known as green because he came to a land which was barren and dry, nothing growing. And he sat down and everything came out luxuriously green. Indicating that the knowledge which comes from this man is not mechanical knowledge. I studied that kitab and that kitab and that kitab and that kitab and that kitab. Already? And then you repeat it over and over and over again for 600 years. Ready? Not this man. This is not dead knowledge. This man has knowledge which is as fresh as the rain. This man has knowledge which brings the dead heart back to life. This man has knowledge which inspires and provokes. This man has knowledge which is located, says the Quran, at only that place where the two oceans meet, Majma'ul Bahrain. And this man has from Allah that which the scholar of Islam requires. To be an alim in akhiru zaman, you need this. More than your dars in Nizami, you need this. Ataynahu rahmatan min indina, wa'allamnahu min ladunna ilma. These two things. He is the personification of kindness and compassion. Rahmah. Everything about him is Rahmah. But Imran, you hear him sometimes pounding and shouting. No, not him. He is Rahmah personified. وَعَلَّمْنَاهُ مِنْ لَدُنَّ عِلْمًا. And we gave him knowledge from ourselves. The most important function of spirituality is connected with knowledge. And so he is someone who receives knowledge from Allah because he's illumined. He has the nur inside of him. Khidr alayhi salam. And if you want to possess the capacity to respond to Dajjal, you've got to follow in the footsteps of Khidr.
And then it became divine. So that was the difference. You know, you have many steps as you lead up, and I do mean lead up and in. There is an inward but an upward sort of journey when it comes to transformation. The Bimi being is here to express itself, speak its expression, to say what it wants to put out into the world. Beamism is about what can you give. So I say to you here and now, are you taking from life? Or have you come here to give to life? Because if you've come to give, then the Beamy Being is definitely the way forward for you.